Hi, and welcome to this course called Bayesian versus Frequentist Statistics. The main idea of this course is to compare these methods side by side in an introductory level. The side-by-side comparison helps to give a better understanding of each method and especially about the main differences. This course is inspired by Professor John Kruschke from the Indiana University. He has built an interactive R-Shiny app that demonstrates the differences between Bayesian and frequentist statistics. We use that app heavily in this course, which lets the listener participate by tweaking the app themselves. Some of the topics in the course include the statistical model, parameter estimation, and hypothesis testing. And we also cover some popular statistical misconceptions. So, let's move on to the slides. The aim of this course is to turn on the light bulb inside your head in such a way that when you come out the other side after the course, you will have a better understanding of the main differences between Bayesian and frequentist statistics. Here's an outline of the course. Comparison of Bayesian and frequentist approaches based on estimation and hypothesis testing. So we'll be focusing on these two topics. Using the R-Shiny app, found freely online. Here's the link to that, and it's also found in the description. There's two main schools in statistics, Bayesian school and the frequentist school. And typically the Bayesians think that they are the better method, this is the way to do it, that's not the way to do it. And the frequentists typically think that this is the way to do it, that's not the way to do it. So they don't always get along so well. But in fact, you really should, these two methods are just tools that you should have in your toolbox and use them based on your situation, based on your research problem. So we'll be using the R-Shiny app developed by Professor John Kruschke from the Indiana University. The app was created as a learning tool, and the main idea is to get a general sense of the similarities and dissimilarities between Bayesian and frequentist statistics. The app contains numerical data only, and it uses a simple model, a two-parameter normal distribution. And although it uses this simple normal distribution model, all the ideas can be generalized to more complex models. Now it's app time. So from time to time, we'll hop off from the slides to the app. And at that point, you can pause the video and play around with the app as long as you want and continue when you're ready. And we'll look at the core structure of the app right now. So the app looks like this. On the left-hand side, you have the data section. You specify data characteristics below using these interactive sliders. For example, here you have the slider for the data mean. When I move it all the way down, you have to wait for a second. You see that this histogram here and here, these are identical histograms, they change. And when you move the slider all the way up, the histogram moved on the right. You can also change the standard deviation. Can decrease it so that your histogram becomes more narrow. And when you move the standard deviation slider all the way up, your histogram becomes more spread out. And here you can also change the sample size of your data. Here's the analysis section. So the model behind this app is the normal distribution with parameters mu and sigma. So here is your data, this histogram, and the black line here is your model density function, the normal density function fitted on top of your model. There's two columns, one for the frequentist method and one for Bayesian. For the Bayesian approach, you can specify prior distributions. So before you collect any data, you can specify prior distributions for the mu parameter and for the sigma parameter. And for the Bayesian, after you've collected or received or seen your data, you construct, or here you can see the posterior distributions for the mu and for the sigma, along with other things which we'll cover in more detail later. So two columns, one for the frequentist, one for Bayesian. And then there's two main rows. So this row deals with parameter estimation. For the frequentist approach, it's somewhat limited at this point. That will change when we move on and have more examples. And here, as we already saw, is the posterior distributions for mu and sigma. And the second row is for hypothesis testing. This is in fact empty at this point, but this you can change these settings here, and everything will change. There's one main learning objective in this course, which is to understand frequentist and Bayesian analysis, assessed by being able to predict and explain the influence of every slider on every cell. So within the app, you should be able to predict when you move, before you move any given slider, you should be able to predict what happens before you move the slider. The second learning objective is to understand the application of frequentist and Bayesian analysis, assessed by being able to set every slider based on situational information. So this means that when you have your research, you have a custom, unique research problem, you should be able to set every slider to their correct positions based on your custom research problem. But the second learning objective is much more advanced. In this course, we focus mainly on the first learning objective. The data in the app are a single group of numerical values. And the sliders can be used to investigate the mean, which could be, for example, the mean milk production of a cow, the mean tree height, and so on. And then also there was a slider for the standard deviation. Again, you could think about examples for the standard deviation, could be the standard deviation of a milk production of a cow, and so on. And there was also a slider for the sample size. So the number of cows in your dataset, for example. Now it's time to try out the app. Open the app in your browser and try out the data sliders. So there were three data sliders, one for the data mean, one for standard deviation, and one for the sample size. So if you wish, you can pause the video now and try out the data sliders. We'll continue. See how changing the data mean changes the location of the distribution. And see also how changing the data standard deviation changes the scale of the distribution. So, for example, if I change the data mean to the maximum 130, I see how the histogram shifted. Now, if I move it all the way down to 70, it becomes more evident. You saw how the histogram moved, the location of the histogram moved to the left-hand side of the axis. Similarly, let's move the data mean, for example, to 100, around 100 here. And let's move the slider for the standard deviation to 30. We'll see that the histogram becomes quite spread out. And if we move the standard deviation slider to all the way to the minimum, 7.5, we see that the histogram becomes quite narrow. So this is how the data sliders work.